As the government and oil companies continue with land acquisition for the East African Crude Oil Pipeline Project, human rights activists have expressed need for the government to first address the concerns of the project-affected persons and consider a holistic approach to compensation. Some of the affected persons from as far as Hoima, Chikube, Kakumiro, Mubende, Vulisa, Chibale, Chotera, among other districts, today met in Kampala and petitioned the judiciary over the delayed justice. They claim that 8 years down the road, they have been filing several cases contesting the peanut compensation for the land, but most of these cases have never been heard, thus justice delayed.
2020, when we got summons from the High Court of Masindi, telling you that we have been summoned to court, we have refused the compensation that government has given us. Because we refused that money due to some reasons. Because that money which they gave us could not even afford to buy land somewhere else, unless you squeeze yourself in other ways. So we saw that the compensation was not inadequate, we refused.
Community start putting the alarm because of poor compensation. Before government announced, it was 2,100,000 Uganda shillings. But community raised their voice seriously. By then, the Minister of Land and Housing Urban Development was Betty Amongi. He went there with the team. Then government make a top up of some money. It reached in 3.5 million.
Dickens Kamugisha, the executive director of Africa Institute for Energy Governance, a body which fights for the rights of the oil-affected persons, retaliated that over 7,000 people have been displaced to give away land for the construction of the oil pipeline. He noted that in land acquisitions and compensation processes, the government should always strive to make the lives of the affected persons better.
The communities in Terenga who had refused the compensation that had been offered as being unfair, being inadequate, the government this time is the one that took the case to High Court. That case was filed in 2020. Within 6 months, the government got a ruling. The court allowing the government to deposit compensation in court and proceed to evict the communities. After that ruling, the communities filed a notice of appeal in the Court of Appeal. It is now coming to 2 years. The Court of Appeal has never fixed the hearing.
In determining compensation rates, government officials have always argued that compensation is not meant to make people richer, but rather restore them to their former positions. The affected people say that the government was compensating them with 3.5 million shillings per acre, which is too little. They are demanding for 21 million shillings per acre.
Whereas in Butiawa, the army has taken over the land, then even the oil company has taken almost all the clan land. So I have so many families demanding that I get them land. And if you are in my position, you can understand the pressure. So attempts to go through the court have failed. Attempts to get government attention has also failed. So what do you expect us to do?
As Uganda hopes to begin the extraction of its own oil in 2025, the construction of the East African crude oil pipeline from the shores of Lake Albert in Uganda to the port of Tanga in Tanzania is underway. Government officials have given hope that all compensations will be carried on fairly. Story by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.